इट इज पंजाब बट इट्स ऑल्सो द होल वर्ल्ड.
क्या जाने मेरे यार है.
चमकीला वॉज नॉट ओनली फेमस इन पंजाब, ही वॉज फेमस in the whole of India and also internationally.
Chamkeela, chamka aise mein, cham cham chamkeela.
And we are DMing each other on Instagram. Okay, he'll send me this singer's profile. Check the very nice vocal texture. Let's call her for, you know, for our next scratch. Or let's call him for this scratch. And I'll DM, hey, interesting texture.
Mainu vida karo.
We have recorded so many people from those messages, from those DMs.
Tracking milestones of an incredible journey spanning more than 3 decades. Rahman Music Sheets. Hi friends, discover the top take as we uncover the wow factor in this episode. Do watch it till the end to grab this musical moment of the day.
Ishq mitaye hai hai nimaye mera ishq banaye.
चमकीला जो दुनिया भर में अपने गंदे और अश्लील गीतों के लिए जाना जाता है.
2024 चमकीला ऑन Netflix unravels the true story of Punjab's original folk rock star, also known as Elvis of Punjab. The highest record selling artist of his time, Chamkeela remains one of the best live stage performers of Punjab.
कलाकार महान है लेकिन तू अपना है चमकीले.
That inspired Rahman and director Imtiaz Ali to shoot and record 17 of Chamkeela's original songs as live performances. Music supervisor Hiral Viradia disclosed how this apparently impossible mission was accomplished. In episode 161 of Rahman Music Sheets. Find its link in the description. Rahman stayed true to Chamkeela's musical ethos while recreating his songs. But for other songs and BGM, Rahman opted to make the vibrant sounds of Punjab resonate worldwide.
They were very clear that we are not going to touch the Chamkeela original music section. So why we rehearsed with Diljit Pariniti so much, not because they needed practice, but to make sure it is exactly how Chamkeela has performed in this particular akhada or this particular concert. We will not change a single thing. So we have not touched the keys. We have not changed the tempos. We have even the hand gestures and the body language and the costume, everything is exactly how it was performed by the original musician. So we're very clear that we will not produce it any better or make it something different and something better or whatever than what it was. Even the audio quality, we tried to retain exactly as it was. In Chamkeela's recording. But with Rahman sir's segment, with his album songs and his background score, sir said, yeah, okay, it is Punjab, but it's also the whole world which is going. Chamkeela was not only famous in Punjab, he was famous in the whole of India and also internationally. So he said we could try and let those things be in the spotlight and sort of come up with something which is Punjabi but universal and tell certain things that Chamkeela, from Chamkeela's perspective, but not in a literal way. So yeah, he did play around a lot in the with the soundscapes, songs like Baja, songs like Ishq Mitaye, Tu Kya Jaane, they are written in Punjabi, but and it has some Punjabi folk instruments as well as where sir has taken liberty and explored it and taken it much further and much deeper.
Tu kya jaane mere yaar.
Chamkila has 6 original songs written by Irshad Kamil and composed by A.R. Rahman. Ishq Mitai, sung by Mohit Chauhan, is a funky, groovy song.
Ishq Mitai, hai hai, nimai mera ishq mitai, hai hai.
Naram Kalja, by Alka Yagnik, Richa Sharma, a track rooted in folk, emanate from the soil of Punjab.
Oh, naram kalja, naram kalja, karam hai niyat, naram kalja.
Vida Karo, by Arijit Singh and Jonita Gandhi, a song with retro vibe makes your eyes moist.
Mainu vida karo, mainu vida karo ji.
Aapne ko geet suna mera?
The film had a happier version of Vida Karo. Everyone was happy with the song, but Rahman was not.
Initially, Imtiaz sir wanted a happier version of Vida Karo, the melody Vida Karo, Mainu Vida Karo, which the song that comes at the end. He wanted a happier version of that to be the love song from Pariniti's side. So we had that. We had a happier version of Vida Karo melody with different lyrics, slightly romantic. And it was recorded and it was shot on that. And everyone was very happy with that. And then when Rahman sir, when Imtiaz sir had come to Chennai with the film to show it to Rahman sir, and we were watching it, and then Rahman sir felt maybe we should change this song to something else because the happy version of Vida Karo is not working. And Imtiaz sir said, no, it's working absolutely fine for him. He said, no, we need something else here. So even though director was happy, Rahman sir went and was like, okay, let me try something. And he made like 5-6 tunes for that and fully produced tunes. And then he made the first one and then Imtiaz is like, ha, it's good. And then he made the second one. He's like, no, I need something else. So it's Rahman sir's fight with himself, you know, no, I'm not happy. Everyone else around him was happy that, okay, this is also good. And he's like, no, we need one more. No, it's still not it. And he had something he wanted to say through this song, but it after 4 or 5 songs, Tu Kya Jaane was made. With Irshad sir had given lyrics, and then Rahman sir immediately composed, and then that song ended up being in the film, and which did so well. Like now people see that we don't see this scene. Even Pariniti said that this song has changed everything because the previous song was very good, but this one is expressing Amarjot's side in a very, in a better way, and it's connecting with everyone, and it's like that butterflies in your tummy kind of a. So fun story.
Chup chup takti hu, kehna sakti hu.
Wo bhay bhayanak tha. Dehshaton ka daur chali thaanthu thaanthu. Nit goli, nit rakt ki holi.
The song Baja underscores the entire journey of Chamkila's life. Mohit Chauhan not only sings it, but presents it on screen.
Khooni khatre mein, Chamkila, chamka aise mein, cham cham chamkila.
Baja was a beast because so many singers, we have 23 singers in Baja. So he had already done a jam of Baja and sent it to Imtiaz, and then Imtiaz said, this is the phrase I like, which was da 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 da, sir singing that da 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 da, just that much. And then I was like, oh nice, such a cool, wow, you know, so excited to be working on an Imtiaz Ali film, and this is sounding really good. And then I came to know the situation it was made for, which is 2 dead bodies being lifted and being taken to the police station. And then when he had come to Chennai and he was narrating the whole situation for 25-30 minutes that this is my situation. The song is still not made yet. But we have this one phrase. And then he said, so this is where I want baja. And I was like, what? Baja is like a celebration. Baja, baja, ba. And then, sir, and then they were in the same pit. So I sort of felt like, okay, that's quite interesting take on such a dark scene, you know, that, oh, it's this and this, you're showing duality and everything. But Rehman sir is like, yeah, let's just get done with it in the beginning, that, okay, they are shot, they are dead. Now let's have a celebration throughout the film. It was again like a 9-minuter before it was released, and then we kept cutting it down. And then Imtiaz is like, okay, so I need different characters singing different things. So we literally went line by line. This line will be sung by college students who are rebellious. These lines will be sung by female farmers who are shy. These lines will be sung by truck drivers. And then we went and we are casting these voices, and okay, this is a solo, this is a group, this is a group of young boys, this is a group of old men. And yeah, so then we did some of that, and then once he gave us the footage, we had to cast every single voice. And then, yeah, Mohit's the whole rap, re chamkila bole teri hik te malai aaye. So those are all his chamkila's song titles, basically, which Irshad sir has so beautifully made a rap out of all his titles and said a lot of things.
Oh, Bapu sada gum ho gaya teri maa di talashi leni.
So we had a lot of singing sections in the baja song first, and rap was never there. And Imtiaz sir was like, I still want to communicate a lot of other things about Chamkila, like the story of his, but I'm not able to do it with the melodies. So maybe because our dara da dara na 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 na, it's very like fast pace. So it's like, if you can make a melodic section which is longer phrases, so I can put more words and tell a story through that.
Cassette vesette tave save uske bike sabse zyada ab tak o ab tak.
And then Rehman sir said ki, no, why don't we just have a rap and make a rap, and then you give me the lyrics and then I will tune to that. And that's how the whole Mohit Chauhan rap section came, which ended up being in the film. He has also acted in the film and he's narrating the same thing, which became the most famous parts. Again, that's something that was added much later.
Hiral, you just mentioned that you had to cast voices for each line of this song. So were these voices essentially from Punjab?
Mm-hmm. A lot of them were from Punjab. Before the shoot started, Rehman sir had called a bunch of people, musicians from Punjab, tumbi players, algoza, harmonium, dholak, singers, to just jam with them. And we just recorded a couple of things, and sir is like, now let's play this. Sir is also improvising with them. So some of those musicians we ended up using much later in the film. And then while we were shooting, a lot of the actors were musicians themselves. So whenever they would come to Bombay for shoot or in Punjab, and I was always there through the shoot, Imtiaz would keep sending, this is an actor who also sings, this is an actor also. So we kept recording everything from, you know, with everyone. And then later put everything together, the voices that worked well with the film and with the song were retained. And then we ended up casting again. Some singers were from Punjab, some musicians were from Punjab, some were from Bombay, Chennai. It was like a mix of people. from all across India.
The way you were selecting singers for Chamkila, for other projects too, are you a part of decision making when singers are selected? Do you act almost like a casting director?
It's all sir, but I'm there when he's deciding, so I don't take any calls, but he will always be on the lookout. I need a new voice like this, like that. And then we are DMing each other on Instagram. Okay, he'll send me this singer's profile, check the very nice vocal texture. Let's call her for our next scratch, or let's call him for this scratch, and I'll DM, hey, interesting texture, like that. So it's always just like, hey, check this voice out. Hey, this guy is from Bombay, let's call him next time we go. And we ended up calling so many musicians, guitarists, singers, sitar players, santur players, sarod players. Especially from COVID time onwards, he loves getting new people and getting young people, fresh people, and jamming with them and be like, okay, everyone should have an opportunity, because people who have work has a lot of work and people who don't has no work. So sir is always this person who wants to break that boundary and be like, okay, let's give chance to new talents. And he's always done that with singers as well. But I'm always there around helping out with, okay, sure, we can get this. Sometimes with final singers, it's a collective decision. Sometimes sir says, I need this singer. Sometimes producer has a preference. Sometimes director has a preference that I hear this in this singer's voice. And sometimes everyone is open for suggestions, so then everyone's just being like, okay, what do you have? Put it on the table. So it's like, okay. Chahe koi sajde kar
da. So that actually means that your message box is always full with music samples and people requesting you for assignments.
It is, I would say, yeah. And we have recorded so many people from those messages, from those DMs that, okay, interesting texture. Oh, this person plays oud, we didn't know. And let's call them, or a harp or something. So even if we don't have a part from them, then sir will make a part so that we call, that person. And some of them work very closely with us. Yashika was one of them who sang Tu Kya Jaane, we found her on Instagram. And yeah, she is incredible.
So all singers and musicians, now you know how to reach out to Mr. Rehman directly.
No. I could do, whatever I can. But please, please do send. And he's always looking for new talent and people who are, passionate and interested.
And I'm sure they can always find you on Instagram.
Yes, Hiral Varadia. Or just DM Rehman sir. He checks his DMs. Yeah, let me tell everyone, if you have anything that you would like to share, just DM it to Rehman sir on Instagram or wherever you can. And he does check his messages and he does respond sometimes. Of course, he has a lot of this thing, but there's nothing wrong in taking a chance.
And they should mark a copy to you also.
Not important, but yeah, sure. I mean, I could, try and help also.
Hiral witnessed Sushant Singh's death. She also experienced how Rehman decided to change the tone and mood of the entire soundtrack of Sushant's last film, Dil Bechara. Also, with stories behind the soundtrack of Maidan. In our next episode, Hiral will be back. Stay with us.
Even though director was happy, Rehman sir went and was like, let me try something. And he made 5-6 tunes for that and fully produced tunes. And then he made the first one and then Imtiaz is like, it's good. And then he made the second one. He's like, no, I need something else. So it's Rehman sir's fight with himself.
Do you agree that this indeed was the moment of the day? Is your choice different? whatever your mind says. Write it in the comments section below. We will be waiting. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, press the bell icon and stay entertained.